We can also tell each other more. Please feel free to make new friends at this town hall. I'm going to bring on the petition authors in a short while, but I'd just like to say I am a straight ally. And I am here today because I think 3778 is wrong, and I don't want my friends and family to be criminals. This is why I am here. Thank you. And now it gives me great pleasure to bring on stage the petition authors. He is a theatre director and filmmaker. He is also the co-artistic director of Wild Rice, chairman of the Asian Film Archive, and director of the Emma Young Foundation. Please welcome Mr. Glen Goei. And to challenge all those titles, his co-author, a trainee lawyer, Johannes Hadi.
A very, very warm welcome to all of you, and thank you for spending a Sunday afternoon here with us. I'm so excited to see so many of you here today. I'm sorry this auditorium can only accommodate 1,000 of you. 49,000 people had to be turned away. Next time, maybe we do the National Stadium? Yeah! My name is Glen, and I'm Johannes, and we want to personally thank all of you for taking time to click on the petition and for signing your name. By putting down your signatures, you are taking a stand. You are making your voice heard, and you are calling for change. A change for a better Singapore. Our website. The Buddha's teachings of empathy and compassion all living beings, encourage us to develop understanding and care for all communities, regardless of their race, religion, language, and sexual orientation. In this same spirit of care, empathy, and compassion, I support the repeal of any law which criminalizes, discriminates, or marginalizes particular groups. Out of the 50,000 signatures that we've garnered online, about 45,000 belong to Singapore citizens and permanent residents. That makes up 90%. And as promised, we've attached the young man who has difficulties coming out to his Christian family. And I trust Johannes, as the younger, self-righteous brother of the protagonist. And of course, take this ultra-conservative, ultra-religious brother. His brother was shown into great turmoil and finding out that the brother that he dearly loved was gay. And I think this really opened my eyes to the difficulties of being and coming out as being in Singapore, which is something that I've never really considered until that point. Ever since then, despite the difference in our sexual orientation, we have become fast friends. On September the 18th, 3 weeks ago, the only time I should look into my neighbor's bowl is to check whether he or she has enough. Now, as a young, straight man, my bowl over. Under a law that criminalizes who they are and how they love. So, really, I'm standing here today in solidarity, out of empathy with the people that I love. I might not be gay, but if I put myself in their shoes, I can imagine how excluded they feel growing up every day, and how excluded they feel every day since. It makes me sad and angry. So I refuse to let Section 377 days speak to me, and I refuse to stand quiet. Thank you. to learn about what we all can do to help Singapore move forward on the road to repeal. We'll also hear later on from some of our leading signatories, and we'll also listen to some real-life stories from the LGBTQ community about the insidious and invidious effects of 3778. And maybe most importantly, we'll also share with you our plan to prepare Singapore for the repeal of Section 3778. I mean, obviously, we care very much about the repeal of this law, but we also care about how it's done. Like it or not, we are one Singapore, and we want to take everyone along with us in our vision for a better, kinder, and more inclusive Singapore. And so, to kick off, please join me in welcoming one of our
mother of civil society, Nelson Mandela. Constance is also a former. Please welcome Dr. Finian Tan and Mrs. Fiona Tan.
Trying to start a family, and what we wish and hope is for our children to be brought up in a society that embraces differences, to be brought up in a country that appreciates diversity and not be raised in a society that discriminates just because one is different. We are all. Every day should be a day where we come forth with action, not just with words. So I think together, Singapore is definitely ready.
We all had our marriage when I last really got married in Bali, and I had my four sons as the best man. Fiona has four bridesmaids. Four of our family good friends. Bridesmaids. Not babies. I'm not often asked to speak in the body of another defense general. You are different. You are different. And as Fiona mentioned, we really need to accept people even though they're different. They can be different in any way, and they are all different in any way. Secondly, a lot of religious people have said that we should assume things that probably have and also women have said that we should. Thank you. majority in a referendum, the minority will by definition return. So, in any case, we don't referendum in this country. Generally, we decide on the B. So, why should this be different? In the business world, we have minority protection. The way to do that is not to referendum anything, and it's for the country to decide, and for the leaders in the country to decide. To give you an example of a minority that would be affected if it was put to referendum, it means it's family.
Last but not least, we have a doctor in this segment who will share with us why it is necessary to review 3778 from a medical perspective. He is the founder and president for Action for AIDS and former director of the National AIDS Center. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Roy Khan.
I'm really happy to be here, Alan. Thanks for asking me. High levels of stigma are associated with lower levels of testing. So, for instance, the whole recent study by Richard Tan, shout out, doctoral student, friend of mine, has shown that the fear of being identified as gay and the fear of being judged by healthcare providers are barriers to testing. In this study, gay men anticipate stigma in clinics. Some feel they have to lie about their sexuality and have described these disabilities as a barrier to sexual orientation. These findings are borne out by the first-hand experiences of our frontline counselors.
saying, well, how many studies have not said that Section 377A won't be proactively enforced? In that case, why must you keep on insisting on getting repealed? What you're about to hear are personal accounts from members of the LGBTQ community of the impact Section 377A has had on them. It contains descriptions of violence, assault, sexual assault. So if you don't feel up to listening to these accounts, you are free to leave the room for the segment, and our ushers will tell you when the segment is over and you can leave into the room. Section 377A is not just a ban on gay sex. Even without being actively enforced, the law has perpetuated prejudice, discrimination, and bullying towards LGBTQ people in our society. These are examples of how the effects of the law have left scarring and how they have impacted three individuals. These stories are contributed by Sayoni and Aware, and we've gathered three actors who have so kindly agreed to read them today. For the first account, please welcome Timothy Wang.
Is shared from Aware's sexual assault care center. The name of the contributor has been concealed to protect his identity. Today, at the age of 24, I am studying at a reputable course at a university in Singapore. My family is pleased with my academic endeavors, and my peers around me are often delighted by my achievements. I went on the dean's list, and I did an internship with a major company. People around me often see the external side of me, a studious and hardworking student, and a sincere and approachable friend. Unfortunately, nobody has seen the darkest side of me. A vulnerable thank you.
last but not least, we'd like to invite actor Dion Young to read the final personal song. Dion, please. This story is set from the Federalist documentation on violence and discrimination of LGBT women. stories from our very own LGBTQ community in Singapore. And Johannes will now bring us to the next segment of the afternoon.
Right. So we've just heard some real and harrowing stories from people.
Thank you, Johannes. You really got very happy, you're very kind in tone. I still have a bit of follow from the stories that we just heard. But the reason why I'm here speaking to all of you today is because it is really because of that stories. So I'm from Pindot. Pindot, we are a movement that's been campaigning for equality and inclusion and the freedom to love in Singapore, and we've been doing that for 10 years. And if there's any
stories will not be so thank you. in Kenya, in Africa, and in the Caribbean. That's why Singapore is already not the other people. If you are personally struggling with health issues, do you want to make sure that you have good enough to do the right thing? In order to find the right support, to ask ourselves, to ask whether the question paper is working or not, ask them, why is our security, the safety, trust security, is it dependent on that? This is not the right way to run the country. We should have a system that is put in place that ensures that all of us get equal citizens in balance. Now, finally, I want to say that many of us will think that the truth is just. And that is just. the request of the government in recent elections and how that they change from that and that, and not to the assembly to the group's time. So one of the things that we need to talk about is for what's on violence. When we want to do, we want to tell you how much of the concerns we got in the community. If anyone out there, no violence, either or not, no violence, one. So, the
Prohibited.
So please bring him in. Respectful, as I said earlier, that's very important. Also, unfortunately, we are foreign friends who are here. Welcome, thank you for coming. But you are here as observers, so we ask that you do respect our Muslim presence. That's the conclusion of the point as well, so let's keep to that. That's it. Let's open it up to the floor. I'm sure we'll have a really good time with it part of the day. Question over there.
My name is Simon.
Just to respond to your question, Simon. So, we have been asked to do a lot of things. And it was really hard for us to remember that if you're a minority, that's not me in Singapore. We are very diverse, we are very diversity, pluralism, inclusivity of all persons in the world is not a new concept.
Thank you. Thank you.
And so we were told that these are the things that we said.
Thank you.
the person, but this is going on a conversation that I think is done by the LGBT, and I am the person who knows.
Thank you. Thank you.
that the emboldened that might be involved in some of the rooms. The community has a good talk from people perspective, there's a lot of honesty here right now. I don't want to invite anyone. Maybe for us, it's the second time or the third time we've been talking about this conversation, but for a lot of people who are growing up, a lot of people who are
Thank you.